This one has a Boston reference.
Fantastic. Good choice.
Because that's where we are.
Yes, we're in Boston.
Yeah, we are.
Boston. Yeah, oh, you're listening to Burn One. This is Amber Rubarth.
Thanks, Chad. That's why you're in here.
See what I did there?
Pro. I'm so pro. It was like a movie scene when you turned on Beacon Street and the sun danced through the trees and touched your arm. I didn't know about your past, if you'd found your perfect match, just knew I hoped I'd be cast for the part. Edge of my seat, I'm on the edge of my seat, I'm on the edge. My seat in the dark, and I'm waiting to see where the next line will lead. I'm on the edge of my seat here in the dark. We took my old green car to the Kansas City bar, and I saw a falling star along the way. Wrote a wish in my note. Folded up the map, then we started driving fast down the interstate. Edge of my seat, I'm on the edge of my seat, I'm on the edge of my seat in the dark, and I'm waiting to see where the next line will lead. I'm on the edge of my seat here in the dark. So I get my pen and write, watch the words solidify on the empty page. Edge of my seat, I'm on the edge of my seat, I'm on the edge of my seat in the dark. And I'm waiting to see where the next line will lead. I'm on the edge of my seat here in the dark. On the edge of my seat, I'm on the edge of my seat, on the edge of my seat in the dark, and I'm waiting to see where the next line will lead. I'm on the edge of my seat here in the dark.
So happy you played that song.
Aw, thanks.
You're tuned into The Burn on Burn One, the Berkeley Internet Radio Network, and we're joined here by Amber Rubarth, who is gracing us with her music. Chad Blinman is also in here.
Here, doing something.
As a fan.
I'm just soaking it up.
And from those days when you were both performer and mic stand, you've come a long way and you've done so many things and you've really participated in your own journey in terms of getting your music out. And I know you've worked really hard and you've worked with a lot of people. Who are some of those people that you've worked with?
Yeah, I feel lucky with a lot of that stuff. One of the first people that I started writing with in Los Angeles was Adam Levy, who is a beautiful guitar player and songwriter. That was kind of a chance meeting. Actually, we were talking about the Hotel Cafe earlier, and I actually met him there.
And was Norah Jones.
Yeah, he was Norah Jones' guitarist for about 7 years, and I had no clue about that. I just saw him playing. He was just starting to do his own solo songwriter thing, and I saw him. I just happened to be there and saw him play, and I fell in love with his songs, and was dorky and asked to sign up for the email list. And he was like, "Oh, what do you do?" And we ended up talking, and a couple of days later, we ended up writing a song together called "Washing Day," and just have, you know, we've played a lot together since then.
It's a great song.
Oh, thanks.
Yeah,
thank you.
It's a good song.
So that was, yeah, that felt really good. And we've done a lot of music since then and toured a little bit. Recently I got to work with a producer who produced my favorite album of all time, which is, he produced Tom Waits' Mule Variations, which is kind of the album that made me go crazy for music. And his name's Jakir King, and he just produced my record, which was pretty lucky because, there was a contest put on by NPR Mountain Stage called the New Song Contest, and I won that, which was awesome. And it was, the prize is to record with Jakir.
Wow.
So that just happened last month, and that was like, it still feels overly thrilling that I can't say it without smiling too much.
Don't hold back.
Yeah.
Yeah. What a great prize.
Yeah, yeah. Totally. It's really cool because to be able to work with somebody like that, on an independent level is really like, it's kind of, you can't do it, you know? Like he just did Kings of Leon and Norah Jones and Cold War Kids, and you know, he's doing a lot of big things, and he's really busy with all of that stuff. And so it's really cool that they set that up as a prize and that he was willing to do it too.
And now he's done Amber Rubarth.
Yeah, just another major feather in his cap. What was it like making that record together with him?
It was incredible. I felt a little bit intimidated at the beginning just with the thought of it, but he's super calm and very humble and really easy to work with. And we connected really well, and we did some pre-production while I was in New York and talked on the phone like every day for about 2 weeks before doing it, just talking about the songs and where they were headed and stuff. And then he put the band together, which was amazing. It was,
wow.
Frank Swart on bass and Marco Giovino on drums, who played on Nora's last record, and Patty Griffin and all these wonderful artists. It was pretty dreamy. The whole thing was dreamy. We were supposed to do 5 songs. That was what the prize was. And in the studio, we ended up doing 8. And then him, there was one more song that I ended up writing last minute. And Jakir was like, "Oh, I ended up writing it with Jason Mraz over email, and I was gonna go out there and record it with him." And Jakir was like, "I want to come," so he flew out there, and we recorded that, and then wrote another song together, all 3 of us, and it was like, so it's a full album now, which
wow.
is great. Yeah,
awesome.
And when is that sort of expected to come out?
August 23rd.
August 20. Wow, very soon.
Yeah,
very exciting.
Yeah, I'm excited. It felt like it felt like this whirlwind of 2 weeks that was just a big dream.
Congratulations.
Experience. Thanks.